Flash floods caused by heavy rains devastated villages in northern Afghanistan, killing over 300 people and injuring more than 1,600 others. Thousands of homes were wiped out, while aid groups warn of damage to healthcare facilities and vital infrastructure. The Taliban government has urged the United Nations, humanitarian agencies and private businesses to provide support for those hit by the floods. Afghanistan has endured a shortfall in aid after the Taliban took over the government in 2021. The death toll from heavy rains in Brazil's Rio Grande do Sul rises to 143 as rains continue to pour in the southern state. Another 125 people remain unaccounted for. Government has already announced more than $2 billion in emergency spending to deal with a crisis that has now displaced over 500,000 people. Rio Grande do Sul sits between tropical and polar atmospheres, which has created weather patterns with periods of intense rains or droughts. And turning now to sports, the defending champions Denver Nuggets regain home court edge in their Western Conference showdown with the Minnesota Timberwolves. The Nuggets evened up their best-of-seven series with a 115-107 victory in Game 4. Three-time MVP Nikola Jokic erupted for 35 points, while Aaron Gordon added 27 points. Anthony Edwards had 44 markers for Minnesota, which now faces the tough task of winning another game in Denver to have a chance to advance over in Indiana. Now, the Pacers crushed the New York Knicks 121-89. That series now also tied at two games apiece. The Philippine Immigration Bureau calling for an urgent interagency action on the influx of Chinese students in the country. BI Commissioner Norman Tancinco has asked the Commission on Higher Education, which heads the Interagency Committee on Foreign Students, to hold a high-level meeting and clarify the role of each agency in giving permits to foreigners. The request stems from concerns on the rising number of Chinese students in Cagayan Province. Based on the BI's records, a total of 1,516 Chinese nationals have been granted student visas there, but as of April, only 485 are currently enrolled. The Foreign Affairs Department recently announced it is planning to implement stricter visa policies for Chinese nationals. Meanwhile, a Philippine lawmaker urging the Marcos administration to scrap a rule that allows the Immigration Bureau to convert tourist visas to student visas. Congressman Robert Ace Barber says the Foreign Affairs Department should be in charge of that, as it is capable of determining whether a foreign national should be given a student visa. A civilian group defending the Philippines' rights in the West Philippine Sea dead set on pushing through with its resupply mission to Panatag Shoal. This despite the claim of maritime security expert Ray Powell that China plans to send a huge force to block that convoy. The mission, which will begin Tuesday, is meant to bring supplies to Filipino fisherfolk in the area. The coalition says China's actions in the West Philippine Sea are failing to intimidate Filipinos. It adds, these have only inspired collective action against Beijing's aggression. The armed forces of the Philippines vowing to stop the suspected reclamation activities of China in Escoda Shoal. See, over the weekend, the Philippine Coast Guard revealed crushed corals had been dumped in the area, leading to what it called the sorry state of the shoal. The PCG believes China is most likely behind it, and the activity could be a prelude to the construction of an artificial island. The AFP now says government is on top of the situation, pointing out the Navy's constant presence in the area to support the Coast Guard.
We will do everything po to deter this from coming to fruition. So, makikipagtulungan po tayo sa all the necessary agencies na monitor naman po natin ito, no? So, all the activities are being monitored and being reported po to proper authorities for appropriate action na din.